The caption for this morning meditation is, I don't think anybody would have heard it before. I never heard this before. I never heard anybody preaching on this. And I never preached on this in the last near 47 years. So a new caption. 10 Commandments. Huh? You all heard about it. The difference is, I'm going to speak to you 10 Commandments of Jesus Christ. 10 Commandments of Jesus Christ. I just read a couple of verses as opening verses. John 14:15. John 14:15. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, keep my commandments, Jesus said. John 14:21. He that hath my commandments. Now you may understand why I said commandments of Jesus Christ. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and I will manifest myself to him. He that hath my commandments, and he that keepeth my commandments. John 15:10. John 15:10. If you keep my commandments. So are his commandments different from Moses' commandments? He says, if you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love. Even as I kept my Father's commandments, as he kept his Father's commandments and abide in his love. When Jesus was keeping his Father's commandments, he was abiding in his love. So when you keep my commandments, you abide in my love. What are Jesus' commandments? And Friday night I was started searching for Jesus' commandments. Jesus' first command, repent. With that, ever so many commandments Jesus was giving. Ever so many commandments Jesus was giving. So it was very wonderful for me. I was able to see all the commandments of Jesus Christ in 5 different categories. All the commandments of Jesus Christ in 5 different categories. Category number 1, Jesus' commandments, some are intended for his disciples in his time. He gave that command to his own disciples, and it was in his time. I can give you a number of examples. For each category, I give you one example to understand. It was in Gethsemane, Matthew 26:36. Jesus came to his disciples. He saw them sleeping. He told them, he told them, sit here while I go over there and pray. So it's not for all of us. On that day, in his time, when Jesus was going to Gethsemane for prayer, he told his disciples. So these commandments are like that many. They were exclusively for the apostles or for Jesus Christ, those who were in his time. Certain commandments were to the public in his time. To the public in his time. Again, it was in the wilderness when he was blessing the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes and feeding more than 5,000 people. He said, he commanded the multitude. he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass. So it doesn't mean that you should not sit on the chair. It was a command given to the public on that day. He commanded them, sit on the grass. He commanded his disciples, sit here, I'll go pray and come. So that was exclusively for the disciples. This is exclusively for the crowd that came to him. But there are certain commandments. It is intended for the crowd at that time, but can also apply to us today. He told those things to the crowd that was at that time. But it can also be applied in our lives. Say, for example, in Mark 8:34, and he summoned the crowd with his disciples. He called his disciples and said to them, he told that crowd of his time, he told his disciples at that time, if anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up the cross and follow me. It was given to the crowd. He summoned them to him. And he said, but it is applicable even to us today. If we want to follow Jesus, deny yourself, take up your cross and follow him. So certain things were given only to the apostles. Certain things were given only to the people. Certain things was given to the crowd on that day, but it is also applicable to us. Similarly, that certain things are given to the apostles, but also apply us to today. It is given only to the apostles, but also it is applicable to us today. For example, Matthew 26 verses 40 and 41, again in Gethsemane, he told them, sit here. I'll go sit here and pray. I'll go over, pray and come. There he said, so you men could not, when he was coming back, he saw them asleep. He said, so you men can't keep watch with me to 1 hour? Keep watching and praying. He's telling them, he's giving them a command. Keep watching and praying that you may not enter into temptation. Keep watching and praying that you may not enter into temptation. So it was an exclusive command given to the apostles in that evening. Keep watching and praying. But it is also applicable to us today. It is also applicable to us today. And number five, the first category, only to the apostles of that time. Second category, only to the crowd of that time. Third category, it is given to the crowd of that time, it can be applicable to us also. Fourth category, it is given only to the apostles of that time, but applicable to us also. And the fifth category, it is for general Christians. It's for all time. Even then he was not specifically telling his disciples, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness. It is to disciples, to the public, for all these 2,000 years, to any Christian. So you can see all the commandments of Jesus Christ in five different forms. But we are very closely going to study 10 basic commandments. And these 10 basic commandments very broadly constitute our Christian living. These 10 basic commandments, in each commandment, there may be a cluster of few commandments. In each commandment, there may be a cluster of few commandments. My dear brother, my dear sister, if anybody asks what you believe, if anybody asks you what is your Christianity, in nutshell, You can say, this is the Christianity that you believe. This is the Christianity you believe. And if the Lord enables you, you read from Matthew chapter 1, or to be very specific, Matthew chapter 4, thereby we see Jesus' ministry unfolds. You jot down all the commandments, whether Jesus told his disciples, or Jesus told the crowd, or Jesus told in general, if it is applicable for you today, jot down all the commandments and start meditating on those commandments. They are Jesus' commandments. If you have his commandments, and if you keep his commandments, you will love him. Otherwise, you say that you love him is hypocrisy. So it's a very good touchstone to know whether you love Jesus or not. Now, I don't think that today alone, I don't know how many commandments I would be able to serve with you. But surely the Lord will make this a blessing. So the basic number one, I call this number one, to start your Christian life, receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. In John 20:22, and when he had said this, he breathed on them and saith unto them, receive ye the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Jesus said, I am going away. I send another comforter. He will abide with you. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. Receive the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God must come into your body. It's a great spiritual phenomena. Many miracles take place. Blind see, deaf hears, lame walks. Even the dead person comes to life. It's a miracle. His spirit has left his body. His soul has left his body. When a servant of God prays, his breath comes back into his body. His breath comes back into his body. It's a miracle. It's a greater miracle when somebody prays for you, or when you pray for yourself, not your spirit that left you is coming back into your body. The Spirit of God, God who created heaven and the earth, the Spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead, that Spirit coming into your mortal body, coming into your clay mold, coming into this earthen pot, the Spirit of God coming into your body is a great miracle. Receive ye the Holy Spirit, to be a Christian. The history of the church began on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost came upon them. The history of the church started with that, on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost came upon them. Cornelius' life started with that. The Holy Ghost came upon them. My dear brother, my dear sister, when Paul was to start his ministry, Christian walk, the Lord anointed him with the Holy Spirit. If anybody has not received the Holy Spirit, you have not fulfilled one of the important commandments, basic commandments of Jesus Christ. Receive the Holy Spirit. I am saved by His Spirit. I believe Spirit is in me. It's only through Spirit I understand Jesus Christ. No. It's not a question whether the Holy Spirit is in you or not. Have you received it? It is a voluntary act. It is an intelligent act. I know that I received the Holy Spirit. Probably I know the date, I know the time, I know the place, I know that instant, how I received the Holy Spirit. It may not be okay with somebody. You may not remember the date. But you all may be remembering that you received it. Is that you believe Holy Spirit is in you? I received Holy Spirit. Ask Peter. When did you receive Holy Spirit? Is it by the seaside of Galilee? No, no, no. Is it in Capernaum? No, no, no. Is it in the temple of Jerusalem? No, no. It was in the upper room on the day of Pentecost. I received the Holy Spirit. Not when I met Jesus. Not when he decided to follow Jesus. Not when Jesus died on the cross. In the upper room, on the day of Pentecost. Ask Cornelius, he will be able to tell you. Ask Paul, he will be able to tell you. It was in the house of Simon. Simon the Tanner. Is in the city of Joppa. It is when Ananias came and prayed for me. My dear brother, my dear sister, you ask Apollo? Yes. Aquila, Priscilla, they taught me about this. They prayed for me. I received the Holy Spirit. So if you have not received the Holy Spirit, you are not fulfilling one of the commandments of God. And if you don't fulfill the commandment of God, how will you love God? How will you love God? If you have my commandments, you love me. This is the commandment of God, receive ye the Holy Spirit. Receive ye the Holy Spirit. To receive the Holy Spirit, three major things you should have in your life. That's why I said in every commandment that we meditate, there will be a cluster of few other commandments. Three things: repent, believe, and be baptized. Repent, believe, and be baptized to receive the Holy Spirit. The very first preaching of Jesus Christ, the basic fundamental preaching of Christianity, repent. Matthew 4:17, when Jesus started preaching, the first thing he preached, repent. Repent. So what do we biblically mean by repentance? The teaching of repentance. The teaching of repentance has got three parts in it. And I'll show you one verse to understand the teaching of repentance. Now if you follow this study carefully, you can help anyone in understanding the scriptures, in leading them in a Christian walk. What is repentance? If you've got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with us to Isaiah 55, verse 7. Make a note of it, it's very important. There you see the basic of repentance. So in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 7, let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord. Let him return unto the Lord. It has got three major parts. Number one, forsake your old ways. There are ways of a sinner. So to get a medical seat, a sinner will have his way. To earn money, a sinner will have his own way. Now you forsake, give up that way. That's the step number one in your repentance. Your old ways. What the people of the world will do in that situation, you forsake that. Give up that. How a college girl will dress in the world, give up that. How a college boy will do in that age, give up that. We are delivered. Jesus, in the book of Galatians we read, he came and died to deliver us from this present age. To deliver us from this present age. Somebody sings, leads worship, and if he doesn't have deliverance from this present age, according to the Bible, is not at all salvation. Not because somebody could sing Christian song, not because somebody could dance for a Christian song. That can be an entertainment, a cultural program, a Sunday school program, a youth program. We have an entertainment. But every believer, the very first step in repentance, he must be delivered from the present age. Give up that. Number one. Repentance number two, in that verse, forsake the thoughts of the unrighteous. Not only are you giving up the way of this world, your thinking process, your mindset about fashion, about finance, about politics, about family relationship, about sin, your mindset must also be different. Give up the mindset of the world. Give up the lifestyle of the world. Give up the mindset of the world. And number three, okay, I have given up the mindset of the world, I have given up the lifestyle of the world. But number three, very, very important, turn to God. Make your face set towards God, heavenward, the Word of God, the Bible, the Scriptures. What does the Bible say? It's not the letter of the Bible, but the spirit of the Bible. But the spirit of the Bible. So when you say repent, the repentance must have these three parts in it. So to receive the Holy Spirit, repentance is very, very essential. We don't pour milk into a vessel that's not clean. We don't pour milk into a vessel that's not clean. So that vessel is very, very important for you to receive the Holy Spirit. For that, to fulfill that commandment in your life, you must have repented for your past. Feeling sorry for the way of the world, feeling sorry for the thought process or the mindset you had, feeling sorry that you have set your mind, your focus on the world system than the word system. It's not the word, it's not the word that teaches you, is monitoring you. What is monitoring you? What is the guiding force? It is the world or the word? It is the spirit of the word or the spirit of the world? Your hairdress, setting your eyebrows, makeup, dress, husband and wife relationship, parents-children relationship, relationship with the neighbors, every part of your life, guided by the word or guided by the world. Your marriage ceremony, your birthday ceremony, the funeral, prayer meeting, Is it guided by the word of God or guided by the world of God? Guided by the world. Turn to God. That's the real repentance. So to receive the Holy Spirit, you must have a heart that repented. Repented from your wrong ways, from your wrong thoughts, and turning to God. The word turn is very interesting in Hebrew. Break and build. Break and build. Break the old thoughts, old value system. I got the right to talk about this. In my college days, one of my nicknames was trendsetter, fashion maker. And the Lord changed it. Now the word of God, more and more, more and more, more and more. Not only in dress, etc. Your relationship with others. So repent, believe and be baptized. Even for baptism, John said, you must bear the fruit of repentance. Without bearing, Matthew chapter 3:8, bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance. Fruits that's meet for repentance. There's a proof for repentance that meets the condition that you are really repented. You must bear the fruit of repentance. The way you talk, in the way you smile, in the way you roll your lips, in the way you roll your eyes, in the way you stand, in the way you behave, in the way that you talk to your mother, in the way that you talk to your children. Bear the fruit of repentance. That's Christianity. That's Christianity. So repent from your wrong ways. Repent from your wrong thought process. Turn to God. That is basically repentance. Bear the fruit of repentance. Bear the fruit that meet repentance. There's the required for repentance. There's the proof that you are repented. So repentance is very, very essential. And to receive the Holy Spirit, repent, believe. Believe and be baptized. So the basic commandment, receive the Holy Spirit, and it has got three commandments in it for our meditation. Repent, believe. What's that you believe? It has got three things in it. It has got three things in it. Number one, believe that Jesus is the Son of God. Believe that Jesus is God manifest in flesh. Jesus was born 2,000 years ago. He was in the womb of Mary like any other child. She came out into this world like any other child would come out of the body of her mother. She was sucking the milk of Mary. Ate ordinary food, butter and honey like any child. Circumcised like any other child, any other Jewish boy. He was hungry. He was thirsty. He was weary. John the Baptist was able to immerse him in water and giving him baptism. The Roman soldiers were able to scourge him, spit on his face, pull his beard, They are able to drive nails through his hands and through his feet. A centurion was able to send his spear by his side. Do you believe that he is God? But to be a Christian, to receive his spirit, you must believe that man who was born out of Mary, that man who was baptized by John the Baptist, that man who was hungry, who was thirsty, who was weary, who was sleeping, that man who was persecuted, tortured by the Roman soldiers, that man who was nailed to the cross, that man whose side was pierced with a spear, do you believe that man was God? Flesh and blood cannot reveal this to us. Only Father in heaven can help us believe that that man was God. That man who walked on the waters. That man who could turn the water into wine. That man by sending his word could give life to a dead person on the bears. That man who can raise up Lazarus from the sepulchre after 4 days of his death. That man is God. Believe that Jesus was God in flesh. It's a great mystery. But to receive the Holy Spirit, you have to believe that. So number one, to believe that Jesus of Nazareth is God Almighty. It was the prophecy in the Old Testament, even 700 years, 600 years before Jesus was born, 700 years before Jesus was born. Unto us a child is given. Unto us a child is born, unto us a child is given. The government shall be upon his shoulders. He is a mighty God. He is. That child is an eternal Father. A child that is born for us, a son that was given for us. He is eternal Father. Believe it. If you can believe that you are a Christian. That child is a mighty God. That child is the Prince of Peace. That child is the eternal Father. God above all gods. If you can believe that, you are a Christian. So receive the Holy Spirit. And Peter said, repent, believe, be baptized, you shall receive the Holy Spirit. So you should repent. Repent from your wrong ways. Repent from your wrong mindset. You should turn to God. When you turn to God, believe this man is God, God manifest in flesh. Believe that. My dear brother, my dear sister, many of us would easily believe that. The second component in your faith, in belief, is the second component. You can make a note, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. Hebrews 11, 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. Must believe that he is. And must believe that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Number one, believe that Jesus was manifest in Jesus is the God who was manifest in flesh. Number two, believe that he is. Yes, I believe he is. No, it's not that. Believe that he is unchanging. From the very beginning he is revealing that. When he talks to Isaac, he says, I am God of your father Abraham. When he talks to Jacob, he says, I am God of your father Abraham and Isaac. When he talks to Moses, he says, I am God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. Can you see that? When he tells Joshua, he says, as I was with Moses, I am with you. God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, God of Moses. As he was with Moses, he is with you. He has not changed. As he was with Sundaram, he is with Robert. As he is with Robert, he is with Will. Can you see that? He has not changed. He is not changed. There may be a difference between Abraham and Isaac, Isaac and Jacob, Jacob and Moses, Moses and Joshua. He is the same. God of Elijah was the God of Elisha. God of Elijah, God of Elisha is God of Job, God of Sam. There may be difference between Elijah and Elisha, there may be difference between Job and Sam, but not in God. He is the same power, the same grace, the same compassion, the same holiness, the same righteousness. He has not changed. He is Yahweh. He is as He is. You should believe that. He has not changed in this 20th century. He was different in the days of the apostles and He is different now in this present Dingre Dingale days, Vada Macha days. He is not different. He is the same. You should believe that. You should not think that God has changed now. God was very rude in those days, very strict in those days. Now God has become weak. Now God has become more tolerant. Now God has compromised with His holiness. No, you can't think like that. You believe that God has not changed. So to receive the Holy Spirit, you must repent and believe. Believe what? Believe that Jesus is God manifest in flesh. Believe. Believe that God doesn't change. He is. Irukkiravaragave irukkar. And third component, believe that He is the rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. That diligently seek Him. He rewards with proportion to how you seek Him. If you come near to Me, I'll come near to you. If you draw closer to Me, I'll draw closer to you. If you give, I will give. With proportionate to how you commit your life, how you seek the Lord, how you want to be a pilgrim on this world, how much you believe Him, how much you believe Him, how much you trust in Him. Abraham was willing to sacrifice his only son, only begotten son, only son whom he loved very much. He was willing to sacrifice for that Lord. How you believe Him. How you diligently seek Him. With proportion to that, He rewards you. He gives you. He gives you. He gives you a good husband. He gives you a good wife. He gives you a good vehicle. With proportion to how much you trust Him. One young man said, I always remember there's a very funny statement, very painful statement. I want to have a wife according to God's will only, but God should not give somebody yada godama. He was afraid that God would give somebody yada godama. He had his own choice. I keep my comments reserved. He had his own choice. I love to keep my comments reserved. I trusted it in God. And the comments are open to you all. The comment is open to you all. For the first case, I say comment is reserved. It's all with proportion to how diligently you seek Him. How much you keep God's will first in your life. How much you want to please God. How much you want to trust God. Those who trust God before men, not trusting God secretly, trusting God before men, with proportion to that, with proportion to that, He rewards. You believe that. You come closer to Him, He will come closer to you. You honor Him, He will honor you. From day one, I honor the presence of God. I honor the Lord's Day. Lord's Day is not my relative's day. Lord's Day is not my uncle day, auntie day, my cousin day, not any other's day. It's Lord's Day. It's not because I'm a pastor. I was 21 years old, 22 years old. Rather, 21 years old, I got saved. I honored God. I loved everybody, but nobody is more important to me than God. Not for preaching. I'm not saying this for preaching. Some people, those who want to become servants of God, I tell them, you have testimony. A few days back, I talked to one boy. I said, you have testimony for your life. Then when you become a servant of God, you can say, this is your testimony. This is your testimony. At my wedding, my pastor said, Pasundaramaya said, a testimony about me. Ithanandedi, Ithanamaniki, Ithanandedi, Inna Kalame, Ithanamaniki, or Inna Adatler Parnianakaterium. My dear brother, my dear sister, you may be surprised to know this, but for your blessing, I tell you, till this morning, when I go to my bath, I tell my wife and go. This morning also, I cannot remember I have gone anywhere before marriage without telling my parents. After marriage, without telling my wife, God is a witness. Similarly, in my ministry path, my pastor knew what I was doing, where I was going. A testimony. A testimony. You seek the Lord with all your heart, He will be found. So, number one, receive the Holy Spirit. To receive the Holy Spirit, you must have three components. Repent. Believe. Believing has three components. Believing has got three components. Believe that Jesus is God manifest. Believe that He is. He's not dead. He is. Believe that He rewards everybody equally. He is not partial. He is not different to Elijah and different to Elisha, different to Moses, different to Joshua, different to Abraham, different to Isaac. No, not at all. The difference is based on how you seek the Lord, how you make a commitment to the Lord. The difference is based on how you seek the Lord, how you surrender the Lord. As I told you, the relationship between my pastor and I was entirely different. Till this day my heart doesn't condemn me. I have any part of my life I hid from my pastors. Today any part of my family life I hid from my wife. I open before God. You seek Him diligently, He will reward you accordingly. My dear brother, my dear sister. So belief has got three parts. And number three, repent, believe, and be baptized. And be baptized. You cannot be a Christian without baptism. Anybody here who has not taken baptism, today surrender your life. If the coming of the Lord is today, or your death meets you today, you will be dying not as a Christian. Nobody can be a Christian without baptism. You are coming into Christ only through baptism. Baptism is putting an end to the old life and starting a new life. Tamil, it's beautiful. Thirumulukku. They go to different places for holy dip. The significance, they want to put an end to their old life, to start a new life. Even 5,000 years before Jesus Christ. In the history, we read about Rama. He had a holy dip in Rameshwara to wash away the sin of killing Ravana by a wrong way. There we see the philosophy, there we see the teaching. In Tamil, that expression, muluku potru. And the connection, muluku potru. And the uravukku, muluku potru. That is, you're putting an end to the world life. So baptism is nothing but dying to the world life, starting a new life. Who should be baptized? A believer must be baptized. A believer must be baptized. A believer who has repented. Repented for his ways, repented from his evil thoughts, repented, turned unto God, who has broken the old life and building a new life, who has decided to be a follower of Jesus, a disciple of Jesus, who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus is God manifest in flesh. Son of God means God manifest in flesh. Who believe that Jesus is God manifest in flesh. Who believe Jesus is alive, Jesus is unchanging. Who believe that Jesus is respect of no person. If you seek Him diligently, whosoever you may be, if you seek Him diligently, He will reward you accordingly. He'll answer your prayers. If you believe that, you'll be baptized. We can't baptize a child. But without baptism, nobody can be a Christian. If any boy, any girl here, there's no age limit. If you are an age limit where you could believe God, you be baptized. Don't choose an auspicious day for baptism. I take baptism on the 31st December. Who knows that you and I will live up to 31st December? Suppose you die before 31st December, you will be dying without a Christian. If you hear His voice today, don't harden your heart. You don't choose your day. In the Bible, on the day of Pentecost, thousands of people, those who heard the word for the first time, they were baptized. They were baptized. In Acts chapter 9, we read about Paul. That day, when he received the Holy Spirit, when Ananias came and prayed for him, that day he was baptized. And in chapter 10 we read about Cornelius' life. Peter went and preached. The first day, the Holy Ghost came upon them. Immediately, not after 1 week, immediately they were baptized. The Ethiopian minister, Philip was talking to him about Jesus. He's on the way. He was baptized. Not after he reached his city. On the way, the jailer, in that night, in one place I gave baptism to a group of people about, I don't remember the number, many, 10 or 13 like that. Exactly in the midnight in a tank, in a temple tank, I was giving baptism in a midnight. My dear brother, my dear sister, be baptized. If you love God, you obey His commandments. I love God, but I don't want to take baptism. No. You can't be perfect. I'm perfectly ready for baptism. Nobody could say that. I tell you, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart. Tomorrow is not yours, tomorrow is not mine. I always remember two cases. I mean, this is not only for you, you can teach others. You can share these anecdotes, these incidents with others. One is a very close relative of mine rose up to a very high level from a very low level. They are very poor people. They didn't have food in their house. They go to a relative's house and they take the kanji water and drink. He studied up to standard 5, became a teacher in those days. Then finished standard 8, a higher grade teacher. He finished 11th, became a secondary grade teacher. He finished college. He finished post-graduation. He became a headmaster. Built a beautiful house. His wife was working, earning good amount. Became a secretary in the CSI church. A very prestigious post in a CSI congregation. He became the secretary. That's the time almost I got saved. I was attending a meeting, maybe a few weeks since I got saved. Attending a meeting, that preacher gave an altar call. Some people are coming in the front. Shocked, awesome. I saw my uncle going in the front. Soon after that meeting was over, I ran to him. I praise the Lord, uncle, because there's very strong CSI man. That pastor said, tomorrow baptism. I asked him, Mama, nalaki baptism. Illa rabatte, unga athala ready aganum. Enak churchil nareya poruppla irukku. Na andar oppu kodutten. Mama, don't delay it, Mama. No. Na andar oppu kodutten. Ba, nee adha pathi illa kavala. I mean, at that time I was just 21 years old. He was a headmaster. Very rich man. My words will be of no effect to him. He was not baptized. After a few months, suddenly I heard a phone call when I was teaching in the school. to be very brief. He was working in his well, removing the mortar. So he was standing inside the well on a stone, lifting up the pipe. There was a plumber helping outside. When he was lifting up the pipe, there was a heavy watts wire in that area, the power wire. Heavy watts. Inadvertently, this pipe touched that wire, heavily electrocuted, had a terrible death. He died without obeying the Lord in baptism. If you obey in baptism, will not these sudden deaths come? I remember another incident. I always quote these two incidents together. Another boy. He took baptism. Returning from the church. He took baptism. Returning from the church. Met with an accident. And died. Met with an accident and died. One died without obeying the Lord. Another died having obeyed the Lord. Today, if your death comes, how will you die? Death anytime, if any, every night I pray, Lord, if I die tonight, every night I pray. Lord, if I die tonight, help me to leave this body and to be with you, Lord. Anytime death will come. Anytime death will come. For anybody, death will come. I'm not scaring you. I'm not scaring you. But are you ready to meet that death? When you are dying, are you in the Lord or not in the Lord? My dear brother, my dear sister, if you hear his voice today, I don't know to whom I am speaking, you can tell her this. You can tell her this. So basically, I wanted to have a 10 points, at least I finished one point today. Repent. Believe. And be baptized. Be baptized into Christ. In Christ. In the name of Christ. Into the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. By immersion. That's biblical. That alone fulfills, the symbolism alone fulfills the essence, the meaning, the truth of what Bible baptism is. You are buried in Christ. In baptism, wherein you are risen with Him. My dear brother, my dear sister, then you receive the Holy Spirit. But in the life of Paul, the life of Cornelius, they repented and they believed. They received the Holy Spirit. Immediately they took baptism. Without delaying, they took baptism. So receiving the Holy Spirit, in my case, I received the Holy Spirit on October 28. But my baptism was November 5. Exactly 1 week before baptism, I received my Holy Spirit. So it can be in some cases, the receiving the Holy Spirit may be a little before your baptism. But these four things, repent, believe, be baptized, that you receive the Holy Spirit. My dear brother, my dear sister, so the first Christian commandment to start your Christian life, you must have received the Holy Spirit. And the second commandment in 4:17, Matthew 4:17, Jesus said, repent. The kingdom of God is at hand. Matthew 4:19, in a couple of verses, in 4:19, Jesus said, follow me. Follow me. So in the Christian walk, receive the Holy Spirit, follow Jesus. If you love him, you'll keep his commandments. What Jesus says, receive the Holy Spirit. Yes, Lord, I receive the Holy Spirit. Second commandment, follow Jesus. What is following Jesus? How should I follow Jesus? I'll continue next week. Shall we pray? If you love God, you'll be keeping up his commandments. His commandments, one commandment, receive the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God must be in your body. That's the first step in your Christian walk. To receive the Holy Spirit, repent, believe, and be baptized. Repent from your wrong ways. Repent from your wrong mindset. Turn to God. Believe that Jesus is God. Believe that Jesus is unchanging. Believe that Jesus is a respecter of no person. He will reward you when you seek him diligently. He shall be found. Be baptized as a believer immediately. Don't delay. Tomorrow is not yours. Obey the Lord in waters of baptism and receive the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead must dwell in your body. When you receive the Holy Spirit, the second commandment, follow Jesus. In your Christian walk, Jesus said, follow me. Matthew 4:17, he said, repent. 4:19. One verse next, Jesus said, follow me. Again and again Jesus said, follow me. Told the fisherman, told the rich man, told many people, follow me. Follow me. If you love Jesus, you will follow Jesus. Commit your lives into the hands of the Lord. Basically, you take a Bible, not only these 10 commandments, but these commandments will speak you the teachings of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Dear Father God, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, O Lord. Thank you for your word to your people, O Master. If anybody here who has not yet obeyed you in baptism, help him, help her obey you in baptism, O Lord. We thank you, we praise you, we worship. I commit your people into your hands, O Lord. If your coming is delayed, help us meditate more on your commandments. And help us keep your commandments in our life. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.